Happy Twilight 4 AM gang. Let's play pretend. Let's pretend that Daniel Callahan got every single thing that he wanted in life. That's my real name for those of you that didn't know that. If I had every single thing that I wanted in life right now, let's see. So I would have YouTube, right? And I would be doing decently well. I would be making videos, pumping them out at a good pace, and I'd feel happy with every single video that I put out, and I would feel like I'm putting just enough of my own personality mixed with what the audience wants, what I know the audience wants, to make a great video that got millions of views, right? Millions of views on shorts and millions of views on actual real quote-unquote videos that can make money, since apparently shorts don't. That's crazy. I got 10 million views on my shorts right now as of recording this, and unfortunately I have made $0. It makes sense, you know, they don't run ads on shorts, but still, just, you know, all this effort I've been putting into it for the past 2 months and I got nothing to show for it. I got a few numbers on the internet, which is cool, but, you know, people say, hey, I'm so proud of you, you did so great, you know, my mom and my girlfriend are being supportive, they're saying that I did something fantastic, but I don't have anything to show for it. You know, I still have my job at Wood Ranch, which is pretty good, but I'm still making minimum wage, you know, sacrificing a couple evenings for 200 bucks isn't bad, but the freedom that would come if I was able to just be creative all the time, man. Anyway, continuing with my fantasy. No, so I'm making millions of views every single video that I put out, and this lasts for, let's say, 2 years. 2 years, I'm getting millions of views on videos. Then, I save up enough money to, you know, do what Logan Paul did, you know, make a grand old merch brand with Maverick and everything, and then turning that into my own thing with, like, the peace sign symbol, right? I could slap that on merch and sell it pretty easily, right? And so I'd make a bunch of money from videos and merch and deals, whatever, advertisement deals, you know what I'm saying? And after all of that, maybe I'd be able to save up enough money to find some, let's just pretend that this exists, some abandoned place in Los Angeles or near Los Angeles in California, some place that has a lot of cheap land, a lot of flat space, because that totally exists in California, in my made-up world. So I've saved up enough money from YouTube for making decent videos that, like, have a good premise and are edited well enough, and sometimes I'll maybe have a cameraman or whatever. Anyway, so I've saved up enough money to buy this little piece of land and put up a soundstage. Right, you know how Mr. Beast did it, he bought all that land and then put up a soundstage, and then he expanded from that, but he was able to make these great big videos just because he wanted to. Anyway, so I buy this land and I put up a great soundstage, and I'm able to film whatever I want to film, you know, if that's a movie or a TV show, as well as YouTube videos. I mean, that would be fantastic, using YouTube to break down the walls of the entertainment industry. I've always thought of myself as just a puzzle piece in a larger puzzle. You know, that's what we all are. You know, Mr. Beast is the biggest YouTuber on the platform, but I personally remember watching his videos when he was, you know, just reviewing, when he was just reacting to bad intros. You know, he's the biggest guy on the platform right now. But what's the longest lifespan of a YouTuber so far? I think it was PewDiePie. He's been on the platform for, you know, around a decade, but even now he's kind of fizzled out. You know, he's retired, you know, it's not his fault. He's retired, you know, it's not like his channel just suddenly lost relevancy, you know. He stopped trying because he wanted to try what he wanted to do instead of, you know, appealing to the audience, which is unfortunately what you have to do in this world. Anyway, Mr. Beast, you know, top dog that he is, it's not gonna last forever. You know, there's always gonna be somebody else that's better, that's gonna pull through, you know, somebody that's able to connect with their audience, and they're gonna be better than Mr. Beast. You know, he's just a small puzzle piece in a large puzzle, and that's what I feel like I am, right? But I want to be a bigger piece. I want to feel like I made some kind of difference in the puzzle. Imagine you make a puzzle. Okay, imagine a picture. right? There's all the colorful pieces that mean something, that you can identify that piece, right? And then there's the sky-colored pieces that just, you can't tell the difference between any one of them, and you struggle to fit them into place, right? So what's my goal as a creator, as a person? I hope to one day be able to break down the barriers between a content creator and an actor. But then all of this fear comes creeping in. So again, perfect world. I'm able to make my own studio, like pretty much copying Tyler Perry Studios, and make my own free will, and have my own free will, not be under the control of a studio or whatever. Now, listen to all of these goals. Listen to an 18-year-old kid talking to a microphone at 4 a.m. about all of these aspirations that he has, and, oh, wouldn't it be so amazing to do all of these things? Thanos once said, reality is often disappointing. Yeah. Come back. Come back to the ground level. Come back. Look where we're at. Ugh, it's really hard to stay motivated when you're thinking about all these crazy, amazing, fantastical things, and now you realize, that's not who I am. It's not where I am in life. Maybe I'll never get there. You know what, maybe I'll die tomorrow. Maybe I'll get hit by a bus in a week, and that'll be the end of Daniel Danno Callahan. Maybe I'll never build a brand for myself. Maybe I'll never amount to anything more than what I am. Maybe I'll never get to move in with my girlfriend, fall asleep next to her. Maybe I'll never get my own studio, never be able to buy a boat for my mom or pay for my brother's college. Maybe I'll never even get 1 million views on a YouTube video. Maybe I'll never be able to star in a Marvel movie. All of these random, sad thoughts that just poison me. But then you start thinking, who am I that I thought I was so special? Right? Why did I always feel like I was meant to be more than what I am? Maybe I am just nobody, right? Maybe I was just placed on the earth to be an influence for somebody else, to let them know not to trust anybody, or maybe let other people see how sad of a person I was, so that way they make sure not to end up like me. I wanted to be the next Walt Disney. Imagine that. Me, a little scrawny, lonely kid. Walter Elias Disney. After 63 years of life, he planted the seeds that made such a giant, amazing company. I mean, imagine that. Why do people feel like they're so important and they're just not? Why do I feel like I'm meant to be more than I am? Why am I so depressed that I'm not? Man, I wish I had a friend to talk to about this. I wish I had a therapist, hell. I just want to be seen by anybody. I want to be heard. But when everybody else has that exact same dream, it feels really hard to keep going. How many other people in the world have the exact same want? How many people fail? Fail. Ugh. Man, I hate that word. I hate feeling alone even though I know I'm not, because it invalidates my feeling of loneliness. And then just makes me confused as to why I'm so sad. I wish I could get a good night's sleep. I wish I didn't feel sad. Am I always gonna feel like this? I have videos that I'm so proud of. I made that Aether video and I spent a year coming back to it and working on it, making it absolutely stellar, and it got 200 views. It hasn't gotten a single one more since then. Really, really hurts. That Kanye, Are You Okay video, I tried replicating Shalat so perfectly, and I thought, hey, everybody that saw his video is gonna see that I made this tribute to him, and they're gonna enjoy it, right? That got 2,000 views, did pretty good, and then after a while, I looked back on it, and I realized people literally only cared because I was imitating somebody else. They don't care about me at all, right? I'm just a copycat. Just a bootleg. It hurts. I want to cry. I really, really want to cry. I miss my friends. I miss laughing. I haven't laughed, like, hard in a long time. I used to stay up into the twilight hours with my best friends, and I would laugh so hard about the stupidest stuff. I miss that so much. I miss laughing at this hour. I miss believing that I had a future. I was just waiting for it to come. I don't know what I missed.